Hello everybody and welcome back to Farming Simulator 17. We're back on Goldcrest Valley today and this tractor is ready to plant this field. I haven't really thought about what crop to go for, but I'm thinking of something like soybeans. I think as it is, although you don't get much out of it, it's very expensive, so you get a lot from it, a lot of money from it. I think it's going to be the best thing to do. So yeah, we'll stick it on a worker and it can just get on with it in its own time. Should be working. Yep. And it's also fertilising as well. So yeah, we can just leave it to just get on with it. Now over here, we have still got a case 1455. I did see a comment 2 days ago. Somebody thought that I had got rid of it and someone else replied to it and said I think he sold it off screen or something. But no, it is here. It's got the baler on the back. And it is going to remain here until we need to bale. So chances are it won't be used today, but we're going to keep it for a while. It'll probably be another 10 real-time hours. It could even be for the rest of the series. We will see. But yeah, really, I mean, there isn't an awful lot for us to do today because everything is either growing or is being planted right now. Field 19 is the only field which is ripe, but that's your sugar beet. Field 24 is almost ready. I'm looking forward to that. And it is, what is it? I've overshot. It is canola. So that will be a very good harvest. In fact, it might even be worth just skipping time until it's ready. However, the forecast is for rain. So that might not be the best idea. I don't know. Let's just, it's going dark now. Maybe we should just skip forwards and see what happens. I think the rain is about to start. Yes, it is going very dark, very quick. Ah, here we go. Very predictable. Maybe we can just skip the day through the rain and then we'll be able to harvest it, you know, when it finishes. In the meantime, we've got some sorting out to do. Probably not the best thing to be doing in the rain, but I don't think it affects it too much in 15. We have got to put our seed and fertilizer up in the top shed over there where I put the plow 2 days ago, one episode ago. So, best thing to do is get a forklift or some front loader or something. The front loader's over there. But we do have the case actually. Maybe we can use it today. Maybe we can. Issue is, no front loader here. Okay, so after a very long morning break we just had, I have now managed to get it to a stage where the rain has stopped and our field 24 is ready to harvest. As you can see here, it is on the first ready to harvest stage. So let's just get straight into it. We've got our Massey Ferguson combine just over here. Did I buy a header? I did, it's over there. Yes, of course I did. I was thinking I couldn't have driven it down the road like this. Have to put it on the trailer. Yes, that is always very loud. So it's a field we've been working on, mainly as a contracting job. But this time we actually get to keep all of the profits from the field. In fact, it's 100% profit because we got paid to do it and we didn't have to pay for the seed in the first place or the fertilizer. So this is going to be really good for us. Hopefully that stays on there okay. I have noticed that in 17 it is quite hard to get a header to fall off its trailer, which is very good because before in 15 it was quite painful. Every bend you went round, if you didn't have a locking script, you were at risk of making the header fly off. But yeah, certainly in 17, it is much better. The header actually locks onto the trailer. So we're going to head over there. We're going to begin. I don't know if we'll be able to get it into one tank. We might be able to, as it is canola. So yeah. You don't get an awful lot out of it, but you get a lot of money out of it. It's this field down here. Somebody said that, you know, I'm buying fields but not doing anything with them. I only half agree with that comment. Reason is, it's because they're growing, so I can't do anything with them. But every field that we've bought will be worked on. Field number 8, which is at the top. That, when I last checked, was still growing. It could be ready now, but it's only a cover crop anyway, so it won't really be anything too special. It's essentially fertilizer. You don't really sell it as such. Some people see the oilseed radish as a very pointless crop. Some people see it as a very beneficial crop. It just depends which way you want to look at it. I would say personally, it is a good crop, but don't do it too many times. Don't plant too much of it, because it can be a bit of a waste of time sometimes. It depends what you're going to do in the field. If the field has never been fertilised, it's perfect, because it will put that natural fertiliser back into the ground. But if you've already done a load of fertilising stuff, it's pretty pointless. So this isn't going to take very long at all. It makes a change though, because usually when we're harvesting, it's for another farmer, so we don't get to keep anything which is in the combine, which is a bit of a shame. But this time, we'll actually be able to sell it. There we are up there. So I have been looking around for the next map to Let's Play. I have a few ideas, but nothing sort of concrete. They're just ideas. So I'm not going to say anything, but I do have a small lineup for the future. It is obviously subject to change because I haven't even decided properly yet. But yeah, it shouldn't be too long until we start the next Let's Play. This Let's Play will be continuing alongside. What I used to do was have two maps going alongside, so we'd have two Let's Plays going. Usually about three episodes of one a week, two of another, and usually one or two episodes of multiplayer. And then we can alternate as well. So, sort of looking forward to getting back on schedule again. I came off the schedule because, obviously, at the release of 17, everything just changed. There's no way I could have stuck to it. But now, as things are settling down, the release is all out of the way, I should be able to get a bit more organised, and it should be make it easier for you as well, because I know that not everybody wants to see every Let's Play. Maybe you only want to see a certain map. So having an actual date for that is, in a lot of ways, a lot better. It's harder for me, but it's still a lot better for you, which is the main thing here. And I think, probably, in the next episode, we will do forestry. I just thought we could be using GPS for this. That would work really well. It's just we need to change the setting. Not 90 degrees, we need to... Is that the rotate? Yeah, that's rotate. That's better. Is that about square? I thought it would be. Yeah, that would do. So, yeah, thank you to everybody who also helped me out with this GPS. Having the shortcuts, Control and W, very, very handy. So I really do appreciate it. That is just a fantastic tip. It saves having to press Control and then having to do it with the mouse. So as you can see, it's steering itself here. I'm not doing that. I was actually surprised about the response that the GPS mod got in my previous episode. I was expecting it to go down really well all around, but some people were very negative. I'm not really sure why. There were some which were very bizarre. Some of the comments said, don't use GPS because it's not realistic at all. But truth is, certainly in the UK at least, in a lot of the counties near me, GPS is very, very commonly used. So I have to disagree with the comment, but I suppose in some countries GPS wouldn't be used at all. So I can sort of see where you're coming from. Now that's messed up there. So this time it's going to be taking just half a head of width. I should have used GPS from the beginning, really, but it's fine. We may even be able to start the forestry today. Most of the stuff we use is going to be rented, but there isn't going to be an awful lot of equipment, because otherwise it won't be worth our time. We're going to sell timber, great big long logs, or actually entire trees. Hang on, still getting used to GPS. Yeah, I don't have auto turn on, so got to stay focused. And yeah, we do have to put the header down as well. we go. Back on track. Anyway, yeah, as I was saying, does it pause? Yes, it does pause. I'll just show you though anyway. This trailer here, this will be most likely rented, although it isn't very expensive. And also, we need to get the dolly. This dolly here, we'll tow it with a tractor. And then basically, with our telehandler, we'll just get the log fork, which is this one here, and load up the trailer. That is all there will be to it, which should be very profitable, I'm hoping. I don't know how much an entire tree is worth, but it should be at least £1,000, I would hope. We'll see. But like just before, a log, a small log which fit in the pickup, that was about £100, so it should be. It should be about £1,000, which would be really good. If we could get maybe 8 trees, £8,000 a load, sounds good to me. It could even be better. Now what I've just done is I've just come back over to the yard very quickly. The harvester is still going, but it's almost full. So what we need to do is take a trailer over to it. Which put Manito out of the way. The Manito does get a lot of use, but it's our main sort of multi-purpose tool around the yard, so that's the reason why it gets a lot of use. Off we go. So as you've probably noticed in this Let's Play, as for vehicle mods, I haven't really got any. Got a few scripting mods such as the ground response mod and obviously GPS. But in my next Let's Play, I'm hoping to have things like Class Lexian combines and stuff. As I think, but I miss them. I love the base game machinery because it's all so well made, but I miss the other brands as well. So I think we'll have a bit of both. We'll have some mods and also some base game machines. Perfect timing, look at that. The auger will be on this side, and we'll be able to unload on the move. So yeah, it is, because we did all the work for the other farmer, like fertilising, it's really profitable, this field. He would have really lost out of this, because he paid for everything and then we just took it all. He doesn't even get the crop afterwards. I think in real life, if you're selling land, usually you would buy it after the field has been harvested. But obviously in Farming Simulator, you can use the way it is to your advantage. This will certainly fill the trailer. There we go. How are we doing for the great demand on this? I bet there isn't any. Canola, we want this one here. Yeah, we could get better prices than that. Although this one here at Maplefield Mill isn't too bad, we can do a lot better. Yes, I still have my icons off. I need to find a setting for that. Apparently there is one in options. It could be here or it could be on the main menu. I have to have a look. Let me just see. Yeah, I don't think I can see it, although it could have a strange name. So it must be in the main options, which is strange because I never went into the main options and changed anything, so it's done it on its own. Very strange. Did I? Oh no, I was going to say, I don't remember knocking it down, but the harvester has done. Into storage this is going to go, and then when we get a great demand we'll sell it as soon as possible. How's the worker doing? Ah, it's hit a tree. Always good to see. Have to go and sort it out. Okay. So it has hit a tree. The combine has finished. Even though it hasn't, because there is still another bit. But that should continue. We'll head back. Finish the job. And finally, go and start leasing. Not something I like to do a lot of, but it seems to be the best option here. There we go, almost finished. So we'll unload it. We could actually wait at the bottom of the field, but we might as well just do it on the move. Save a bit of time. I suppose there is a possibility here that this is even going to fill this trailer as well, as it's not very big. It'd be good if it does. Even more money for us. Oh no, that is it. Not very impressive. In that case, I'm going to park down here, and in a second it'll get to us, and we'll be able to just completely empty it, and then pack up. At least the forecast now is for just sunshine, it's really good. Sort of limits what you can do if it's raining. Well, that's it, go home early. They don't even unload before they go. I think that was everything. Yeah, that's good. Okay then, so we'll park this just here. And for the first time ever in 17, I'm going to try the Follow Me mod. So we need to take the header off, attach it to the harvester, put the auger in too. Okay, hopefully. Don't want the worker flipping it off. Oh, okay. My lining up skills there were awful. Right. Okay. So, I'm assuming it is exactly the same idea as in 15. Let's just see. Or maybe not. Maybe it didn't enable properly, or maybe it's just not working. Who knows? Yes, it's definitely enabled in the game, so why wouldn't it work? Aha, there we go. That's working. Fantastic. It does of course mean we need to go through the yard first, as we don't want the harvester to go up the tipping pit. That would look ridiculous. Although actually no, we can put it in here. We could park the harvester in here. Not sure why it's lagging a bit. Will it fit in there? I don't know. Yeah, it should do. That'll do for me, that's fine. Stop! Stop, you fool! Oh, we'll sort that out. That didn't go too well. Oh well, just put it there, that'll be fine. And then we can tip this. I don't know if we're going to use this tractor for towing the trailer, the logging trailer, or if we go for something else. I suppose this one's got the power, so it wouldn't be a bad idea. And that is it for the metal tech. In here as well. Yeah, as for moving the fertilizer and stuff, we'll just do it another day. It's nothing too important, so that'd be a bit of a waste of a video if we're just moving that for the whole video. It would also be quite boring. In fact, I might even do it off screen. We will see. Right, so we're going to need the money too as well, so it might be worth, yeah, I don't know. I don't know if the Manitou would be able to tow. You'd have thought it would be able to. I park this here for now. We could use Follow Me again, but yeah, I think it's probably going to be easier if I just take this on my own. So what we need to pick up is the log fork, the dolly, and the trailer. And this thing should be able to, you know, transport all of that, hopefully. So we'll give it a go. If all goes badly wrong, which it usually does do, then we'll just come back for the case. Really can't see why it wouldn't be able to tow the trailer though. That work is still going. In fact, the field's already growing. That's strange. Why is it? It can't already be on. Who's. What the. I'm sure I said that's slow. That's weird. have also now worked out how to do the ploughing on the GPS model as well. You need to do an offset. That is where I was going wrong before. So I'll try again in another episode, doing a bit of ploughing, making sure the offset is set up correctly. Here goes. So, first of all, the dolly. This should be very cheap. Leasing is £990 as the initial cost, and then per hour, which shouldn't be too many, £450. Yeah, we don't need to put wide tyres on or anything, that seems strange. I suppose that is just for flotation when you're in a wet area. And then we need to go to forestry equipment, which is here. Get this, and this is, yeah, again, we're going to make this money back so easily. Wheel setup, wide tyres, yeah, I don't think we'll bother. A bit of an unnecessary expense at this stage. So, oh wow, look at this. Why am I so amazed? It's just a trailer, but yeah, it looks good. That costs us £2,860. Oh, and also we need to get the log fork too. Mustn't forget that. If I go all the way back without it, look at that. It doesn't actually fit to this. Must fit to a ball type, is it? Strange. So yes, I have wasted time. I could have just brought it on Follow Me. But at least we did have to come here anyway with the telehandler. So we'll get the log fork. And that is £374. So all very cheap today. Very nice to see. We'll get that fitted on. We'll take it back. And actually, no, I'll probably just get Follow Me to bring them both back. It'll be easier. There we go. Oh yeah, I've got some funny backward control where it automatically opens the grab. I'll have to change that for tomorrow's video. Today is just sort of set up. Here we are in the Case PM White 5CVX. This should attach. If this isn't attached to it, then I don't know. That would be strange. That's good. Right. In cab view, always easier for this kind of thing. Get it attached to the fifth wheel, and off we go. This time I'm going to have to try and perfect the Follow Me. I think it was travelling too close and then I pressed the wrong button to cancel it, so that didn't really work. But this track seems like the obvious choice for the trailer. Nothing small about this trailer. And because it is set wrong, it means I can't close the grab up. Definitely something wrong there. Oi, stop. Stop. Ooh, we're changing people very quickly. So what we need to do here is, well, would you stop ramming? Stop ramming. It's awful. We need to change the head distance to something much larger, as it is getting very, very confused. That should work. Should start to follow. There we go. And this time it won't crash into us. It'll always leave quite a big gap between the back of the trailer and the front of the Manitou. The only issue is, with all the lunatic drivers who pull out of these roads here, they could very easily crash into the Manitou, which would be slightly annoying. How many times have we been crashed into from people pulling out of here? Oh yeah, we need to decide where we're actually going to as well. Where are we going? We need to go to a good place. Not somewhere we've been too much before. Maybe the place near to Field 20, because I like that place. It's a good place to go to. And it's also not too far away from the yard. Or we could go to the place above Field number 5. We shall see. Yes, I've decided to go to the place above Field 5. We have been there before, it was a nice place to be, and it's also a very big forest as well, so I think it'll look pretty good in a video. A lot of flashing lights are about. Everything is being illuminated by flashing beacons. So you can see the clump of trees over there, that woodland, that is one of them. You have to access it over that bridge, I believe. That is the place where we had that weird issue of the trees just sort of sinking into the ground after cutting them. So I won't bother with that area. It could have been fixed by now, but I'm not going to bother. I prefer the forest up here anyway. So we'll just keep going. Manitou is still following. Good. And yeah, we should have a very good logging session tomorrow, I'm hoping. Some people hate it. Some people love it. I am going to reserve judgment until I've actually done it in 17. I've not ever done any proper forestry in FS 17, so I look forward to seeing if it's any different to 15. I think it's quite similar, but I can't say for sure. Yeah, yesterday's multiplayer video, you might have noticed that the forager was very loud, and then all the other machines I used in that video were very quiet. I didn't change the game volume, it's just the forager, for some reason, is very loud just as it is. I don't know why it's so loud, but it is. So if you couldn't hear me too well, then I'll try and change it for next time. Obviously it's too late for yesterday, but yeah, it was surprising how loud it was. You can feel it being pulled back. If this trailer was full, I don't know if this tractor would be able to manage it. It's, well, 8 or 9 miles per hour. That's flat out up here, empty. We shall see, but I'm sure you can already appreciate what a nice area this is. Love this area of the map. And a good thing about in 17 is there's a lot more space to do the tree felling and loading up and all that, so if we put this about here, well, probably not in the middle of a tree, but about here, then we'll have enough space tomorrow to be able to load it up without stuff getting in the way. Right. Here it is. Finally. Following our track perfectly by the look of it. Yep, that's all good. Keep going. Keep going. Okay. So, yeah, look forward to it. Hopefully it's going to turn out to be a pretty decent video. But you know what my forestry is like. Sometimes it's quite good. Other times it's absolutely unbearable. So we shall see. Anyway, that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. And I hope to see you again in the next video. I was going to say bye for now, but then we've got a shack up here. I've investigated it before because I didn't know what this was. It's a welding helmet. From the side, it doesn't look like it is, but then obviously it is. Now it's clearly a welding helmet. A mask. Big grinder. And a torch. So yeah, see you again soon. Bye for now.